So dear students, so we are going to start with our lecture number 24, that is free torsional vibration of gear system. So this is about, this is seventh lecture in unit number 3, that is 2 degrees of freedom system undamped vibration. So up till now we have seen the linear vibration, then combine linear vibration of two rotor system, then combine rectilinear and rotational vibration of two rotors, 2 degrees of freedom system. Then after that we have seen free torsional vibration of two rotor system, then free torsional vibration of three rotor system. So today we are going to see the free torsional vibration of gear system. So torsional vibration of gear system, this is the today's topic. So many times the torsional vibration are also observed in gear system. Many times the torsional vibration is also observed in case of gear system or in gear system. This leads to, because of this torsional vibration, this leads to high dynamic load in gear system. It leads to high dynamic load on gear system. Because of this torsional vibration, there is a high dynamic load in the gear system, and hence there may be a failure of gear tip because of high dynamic load. So a gear system, that is torsional vibration of gear system, is shown in figure. So this is a figure that there is a rotor, that is, this is rotor A. Then this rotor, this is first shaft which is connected between a rotor and gear C. So there is a gear pair which is in contact with each other. So this is a rotor A having diameter DA. It is connected to a gear C. This shaft is supported by these bearings. So these are the bearings. Similarly, there is shaft 2 having diameter DB, which is connect the gear D with rotor B. So this is your actual gear system, which consists of two rotors and one gear pair, that is gear C and gear D. There is shaft first, which connects rotor A with gear C, and there is shaft 2 which connects the gear D with rotor B. So the shaft first having diameter DA and the shaft 2 having diameter DB. Then the between rotor A and this gear pair, the central distance, it is L1, and again central distance between this gear pair and rotor B, it is L2. So this is your actual system. Actual system. So this rotor A, it having some inertia, that is IA. Gear C, it having some inertia, that is IC. Gear D, it is having also some inertia, that is ID. And rotor B, it is having some inertia, IB. So this is the gear system which is shown in figure. So the gear system which is shown in figure is consist of, there is shaft 1 which carries rotor A. It is also called as prime mover. A prime mover, it can be electric motor, it can be IC engine or anything. At one end, and other end there will be pinion. That is gear C is your pinion. The shaft 2 carries the gear which is messing with gear at one end, and rotor B which is application. Now it may be any application, like say pump, it is an application. Compressor, it is an also application. So this is an application which is consist of rotor B. at other end. So this rotor A, which is the prime mover, and rotor B, which is as the application. So this is prime mover. It may be electric motor, it may be IC engine or anything. And this is maybe your application. So your application, it may be a pump, compressor or anything. So this may be a application. Now this system, this actual gear system, it can be replaced by an equivalent system. It can be replaced by an equivalent system of continuous shaft carrying rotor A at one end. There is one continuous shaft having same diameter. There are two different diameter in actual system, but equivalent system, there is one a continuous shaft having same diameter. This system is replaced by an equivalent system of continuous shaft carrying rotor A at one end and equivalent rotor B dash. It is important. It carries a rotor A in one end and equivalent rotor B dash at other end. So if the inertia of gears is negligible, if inertia of these gears, that is IC and ID, are negligible, then system will become equivalent to two rotor system. The system will become equivalent to two rotor system. After neglecting this inertia of gears, that is gear C and gear D, then your system will be two rotor system. And if inertia of gears are considered, if we consider the inertia of gears, then the system will become equivalent to three rotor system. Then system is become equivalent to three rotor system. So this is an important concept. So if we consider this inertia of this gear pair, that is gear C and gear D, then the system is three rotor, and if we neglect that inertia, then your system will be two rotor system. So first case, if we neglect the inertia, then your system becomes two rotor system. So rotor A, and this neglecting inertia and this rotor B, it becomes rotor B dash, that is equivalent rotor B dash. This is actual rotor, but it becomes equivalent rotor B dash. And your equivalent diameter of the shaft is one of the diameter, either D1 or D2, either one of the diameter D1 or D2, either shaft 1 diameter D1 or shaft 2 diameter D2. So I can take any one. So I have considered D equivalent is equals to D1. So this is your actual system and this is your equivalent system. So in actual system, there is length L1 and L2, but in equivalent system, the length is replaced by L1 and this will be L2 dash, because this is equivalent rotor is there. So there is L2 dash, and total length, that is L1 into L2 dash, it is total equivalent length LE. This is the total equivalent length LE. So this is this figure B. It is the equivalent system by neglecting the inertia of gear. So if we consider the inertia of gear, next, if we consider the inertia of gears, then there will be a system becomes three rotor system. So there is rotor A, then this is rotor B dash, that is equivalent rotor. there is another rotor which is rotor C dash, and this rotor consisting or considering the inertia of gear C and gear D. There is a rotor C dash, and the equivalent diameter is D1 between this rotor A and rotor C dash, and between this rotor C dash to rotor B dash. This equivalent shaft diameter is equals to, we can take any one diameter. Then again length is same. So this is L1, this is L2 dash, and total equivalent length is your L. Only by considering the inertia for inertia of gears, we are going to add one rotor, that is equivalent rotor C dash. So these are the two important condition in case of gear system, that is equivalent system by neglecting inertia of gears and equivalent system by considering inertia of gears. This is neglecting, it becomes two rotor system. By considering, it becomes three rotor system. So in order to reduce the given system into a torsionally equivalent system, the following assumptions are made. So these assumptions are very much important. So first assumption is inertia of gears and shaft are negligible. It is for first condition when we consider torsional equivalent gear system into two rotor system, in which we neglect the inertia of gears and the shaft is always negligible. Then there is no backlash in gear pair. There is no backlash in gear pair. Third, the gear teeth are rigid and they are always in contact with each other. And fourth, the gear teeth do not distort under the load, under the dynamic load or under the load, the gear teeth are cannot distort. Let DA and DB be the diameter of shaft 1 and 2. L1 and L2 be the length of shaft 1 and 2. IA and IB be the mass moment of inertia of rotor A and B. Omega A and omega B are the angular speed of rotor A and rotor B. Therefore, we can write gear ratio G is equals to omega A upon omega B. Omega A upon omega B, because the shaft first is rotating at the speed omega A and shaft second is rotating at rotating speed of omega. So gear ratio is omega A upon omega B. That is nothing but the angular speed of pinion upon angular speed of gear. Then D is the equivalent shaft diameter. Then next one is LE is your equivalent length. IB dash is your mass moment of inertia for rotor B dash. IC dash is mass moment of inertia for rotor C dash. Omega B dash and omega C dash are the angular speed of rotor B dash and C dash. So these are some nomenclature which are used in case of gear system. So our first case is case number one, that is torsional vibration of gear system by neglecting inertia of gears. So by neglecting inertia of gears, the system becomes two rotor system. So if the shaft are not strained beyond the elastic limit, each rotor in gear system will oscillate with simple harmonic motion. The two rotors, that is rotor A and rotor B, will reach their extreme position at same instant, and at this instant position, that is whole energy of the system will be strain energy. We know that at extreme position or at displaced position, the whole energy will be strain energy, and at mean position the whole energy will be kinetic energy. So when rotor A and rotor B will reach at extreme position at same instant, at that instant whole energy of the system will be strain energy, that is nothing but the potential energy, and it is due to the twisting of two shaft. The two rotors A and B will also pass through same equilibrium position or mean position at same instant, and at this instant whole energy of the system will be kinetic energy. So at equilibrium position or at mean position, your whole energy is your kinetic energy of the rotation of the rotor. So the condition for two systems to be equivalent, so what are the condition? So there are two conditions. So I will consider the first case, that is when the gear system, then we neglect the inertia of gears, so it becomes two rotor system, that is as shown in figure B. So the what is condition one? That is the kinetic energy of equivalent system, it should be equals to kinetic energy of original system. So what is your condition? So this is your actual system, and this is system is equivalent system by neglecting inertia of gears. So the kinetic energy of this actual system, it must be equals to kinetic energy of this equivalent system. So in actual system there is rotor A, gear C, gear D and rotor B, but in actual system there is rotor A and rotor B dash only. So what will happen? So kinetic energy of actual system is equals to kinetic energy of gear system. Therefore kinetic energy of section L1 plus kinetic energy of section L2 is equals to kinetic energy of section L1 plus kinetic energy of section L2 dash. So if we see the actual figures and equivalent figures, so in actual figure there are length, this is L1 and L2, and in equivalent system there is length L1 and L2 dash. So therefore kinetic energy for length L1 should be plus kinetic energy of section L2 should be equals to kinetic energy of section L1 plus kinetic energy of section L2 dash. So kinetic energy of section L1 and kinetic energy of section L1 gets cancelled. So remaining is kinetic energy of section L2 is equals to kinetic energy of section L2 dash. Now if you see the kinetic energy for section L2, there is rotor B. So there is rotor B. So rotor B has inertia IB and angular speed as omega B. So kinetic energy in case of torsional system, it is 1 half I omega square. 1 half I omega square. In case of linear system, the kinetic energy is 1 half m v square. But in rotational, the mass is replaced by mass moment of inertia, and omega is v, that is velocity, linear velocity is replaced by angular velocity, and mass is replaced by mass moment of inertia in case of rotational system. So it becomes 1 half ib into omega b square is equals to, now for section L2 dash there is rotor b dash, So that becomes 1 half ib dash, and speed is again omega b dash square. Now in 1 half get cancelled. Now if we consider the equivalent system, the speed of this rotor A and rotor B dash, it is same because the shaft speed is same. So the speed of rotor B dash, that is omega B dash, is equals to the shaft speed or angular speed of this rotor A, that is omega A. So we can write omega B dash as omega A. So what will happen? So IB omega B square into is equals to IB dash. Now this omega B dash is equals to omega A. So therefore IB dash is equals to IB omega B upon omega A square. Now we know that what is G? G is nothing but A upon B. So it becomes 1 upon G. So IB dash is equals to IB upon G square. So this is the condition when we consider the kinetic energy. So from that we can find out the IB dash. So what is value of IB dash? IB dash is equals to IB upon G square, where G is gear ratio, and this gear ratio is omega A upon omega B. Gear ratio is omega A upon omega B in actual system. So actual system having two shafts, so two shaft having two different speeds, so omega A and omega B. Now what is your second condition? The second condition is condition 2. The strain energy of equivalent system must be equals to strain energy of original system or actual system, same as like kinetic energy. So the strain energy of actual system is should be equals to the strain energy of equivalent system. So strain energy of section L1 plus strain energy of section L2 is equals to strain energy of section L1 plus strain energy of section L2 dash. So again, strain energy of section L1 and strain energy of section L1 get cancelled. So remaining is strain energy of section L2 is equals to strain energy of section L2 dash. Now this potential energy, in case of linear system, the potential energy is force into linear displacement, that is 1 half force into linear displacement. So in case of torsional system, the force is replaced by torque, and linear displacement is going to angular displacement. So strain energy for section L2 dash becomes 1 half T2 into theta 2. Similarly, for L2 dash, it becomes 1 half T2 dash into theta 2 dash. So this is first equation. Now we know that T by J is equals to D by G theta upon L. This is your torsional formula. So from that we can find out the value of T. So what is value of T? T is equals to G J theta upon L. So J2 is your polar moment of inertia of shaft 2, and J2 dash is your polar moment of inertia of equivalent shaft. So it is pi by 32 D2 raised to 4, and it is pi by 32 D raised to 4 because it is equivalent shaft J2 dash and it is shaft 2, that is for length section L2. So what will happen? So that becomes our equation is T2 into theta 2. So what is value of T2? G J2 theta 2 into theta 2 upon L2 is equals to G J2 dash theta 2 dash into theta 2 dash L2 dash. So we have to put that value in this equation. So T2 becomes Gj 2 theta 2 and L2. And T2 dash becomes T2 dash Gj 2 dash theta 2 dash L2 dash. So this is the equation. Gj 2 theta 2 into theta 2. This is multiplication of theta 2. And it is again multiplication of theta 2 dash. So that becomes Gj get cancel. So J2 theta 2 square upon L2 is equals to J2 dash theta 2 dash square upon L2 dash. Similarly, what is value of J2? Pi by 32 D2 raised to 4. Now what is value of theta 2? Now we know that the value of theta 2, it is nothing but the theta is nothing but the omega t. So theta 2 is nothing but the omega 2, that is nothing but the omega b. Second shaft is omega b. So omega b t square upon L2. Similarly, pi by 32 d raised to 4 into omega b dash into t. Now for equivalent system, there is omega b dash. There is equivalent system, there is b dash term. So omega b dash into t is equals to 0. Now we already know omega b dash is nothing but the omega a. So put that value. So we get pi by 32 get cancel. Then t, t get cancel. So remaining term is L2 dash. If we take L2 dash to this side, so that becomes L2 dash is equals to this L2 goes to this side. So L2 into this D2 raised to 4, it is in denominator, and D raised to 4, it is in numerator. So L2 into DE upon D2 raised to 4 is equals to omega B dash upon omega B bracket square. So what happened? This pi by 32, pi by 32, this pi by 32 get cancelled, TT get cancelled. So this L2 dash goes to this side and L2 goes to this side. So that becomes L2 dash is equals to L2. Now this D2 raised to 4, it is in numerator, so it goes to this side. So DE upon D2 raised to 4. Again omega B dash and this omega B goes to this side. So omega B dash square upon omega B square. So this is this. So we get the value of L2 dash. Now put the value of omega B as omega A. So we get L2 dash is equals to L2 DE upon D2 raised to 4 into omega upon omega B raised to 4. And what is value of omega upon omega B? It is G. So that becomes L2 dash is equals to G square L2 DE upon D2 raised to 4. This is for to find out the equivalent length. So after calculation of L2 dash, we can find out the equivalent length. That is LE is equals to L1 plus L2 dash. The value of L1 is already known to us, and L2 dash we have calculated from this formula. So these two formulas are very much important when we are neglecting these two terms. That is, first formula is IB dash. So IB dash is equals to IB upon G square. And your second formula is very much important. That is this formula. That is LE, that is L2 dash is nothing but the G square L2 DE upon D2 raised to 4. So if you have to find the equivalent length, so LE is equals to L1 plus L2 dash. So that becomes L1 plus G square L2 DE upon D2 raised to 4. So this formula is very much important. Now this is all about by considering inertia, by neglecting the inertia of gears. Now second, if we neglect, if we consider the inertia of gears, so second system, the torsional vibration of gear system by considering the inertia of gears. We have to consider the inertia of gears. So there is additional rotor. By considering inertia of gears, there is additional rotor C dash must be placed at a distance of LA from rotor A. And the mass moment of inertia of rotor C dash can be obtained as follows. So we have to find out the value of IC dash. IB dash is already known. So we have to find out the value of IC dash. So if we consider figure, so this is figure. So this is your actual system. And by considering inertia, it becomes this three rotor system. So if consider this three rotor system, there is rotor A, rotor B dash, rotor C dash, then there is length L1, L2 dash, and LE, and there is equivalent diameter D. So we have to find out this value, that is IC dash, and we have also find out the value of L2 dash, because L1 is already known to us. So for that, again, we have to use the two conditions. L2 dash is already known to us, because L2 dash is already known to us. Only we have to find out the value of IC dash. So for that, we have to consider the kinetic energy. So the kinetic energy of actual system is equal to kinetic energy of equivalent system. So the kinetic energy of section L1 plus kinetic energy of section L2 is equal to kinetic energy of section L1 plus kinetic energy of section L2 dash, that is equivalent length LE. So for kinetic energy of section L1 in case of actual system, there are rotor A and pinion C. So that becomes 1/2 IA omega A square plus 1/2 IC into omega A square. That is A rotor and C gear. It is in one shaft. That is rotor A. Shaft A. That is omega A. Plus the second shaft having speed omega B. It has two system, that is one is gear D and rotor B. This is for actual system. So if we take your actual system, so we have to consider all this. So this shaft 1 is rotating at angular speed of omega A. So this is rotor A, so IA. So and this is gear C having mass moment of inertia IC. So what is kinetic energy of this section? 1/2 IA into omega A square plus 1/2 IC into omega A square. Similarly for second shaft, this shaft is rotating with an angular speed of omega B. So what is the kinetic energy of gear D? Is ID, that is mass moment of inertia of gear D, into omega B square plus 1/2 IB into omega B square. So 1/2 IA omega A square plus 1/2 IC omega A square plus 1/2 ID omega B square plus 1/2 IB omega B square. Now we have to take the equivalent system. Now in case of equivalent system, there are three rotors, that is rotor A, rotor C dash, and rotor B dash. Now for rotor A, 1/2 IA into omega A square. So if we take this figure, So there is rotor A. This having shaft, it is rotating with omega A, and this shaft it is rotating with omega. So this rotor A having kinetic energy 1/2 IA into omega A square. This rotor having mass moment of inertia I C dash. So 1/2 I C dash into omega C dash. And this I B dash into omega B dash. So your equation becomes 1/2 I A into omega A square, 1/2 I C into omega B square, B dash square, and 1/2 I B into omega B dash square. Now, in that, this I B terms get cancelled, and I A term get cancelled, because this I A get cancelled. Now I B dash and omega B dash, it is also get cancelled, because omega B, it is nothing but the omega B dash. We know that the I B dash is nothing but the I B in upon G square. So what is value of G square? It is omega. So I B is nothing but the omega B square upon omega A square. So this is nothing but the value of, and into omega B dash. Now omega B dash is nothing but the omega A in case of two rotor system. So omega A cancel, so remaining thing is IB into omega B. So this IB into omega B square, this IB into omega B square get cancel. So our remaining term is this term only, that is C and D terms. So 1/2 IC into omega A square plus 1/2 get cancelled. So IC into omega A square plus ID into omega B square is equals to this term. 1/2 get cancelled. So that is IC dash omega B dash square. Now again, omega B dash is nothing but the omega A. Omega B dash is nothing but the omega A. So if we, this is omega A and this is value of, now if we divide this left hand side only by omega A square, so that becomes IC plus ID upon omega A square, and that becomes omega B upon omega A square, so that becomes G square is equals to omega A square. So omega A square get cancelled. So your remaining term is IC dash is equals to IC into ID by G square. Or another, we can take this divided by omega A square, so that becomes IC. This ID omega B square upon omega A square, so that is nothing but the ID upon G square. So IC plus ID upon G square, and this omega B square, omega B dash upon omega A, that is nothing but the omega A upon omega A, that is 1. So that is IC is equals to IC dash is equals to IC plus ID upon G square. So in case of three rotor system, if you have to find the value of IC dash, so that value IC dash is given by IC is equal, IC dash is equal to IC plus ID upon G square. So this is the gear system, that is torsional vibration of gear system, either by considering the inertia of gear C and D, and or by neglecting the inertia of gear C and D. By considering, it will get three rotor system, and by neglecting of inertia of gears, it becomes two rotor system. So this is all about today's lecture. So thank you.